I would like to play first. Alright, this hand is quite strong. I don't get to cast a turn to him most games here, since I have to draw an actual swamp, but I still have Mana Prism, so I'll eventually be able to cast it. Alright, Dark Hatchling is not a bad draw. I've got 4 mana total. Technically, the only spell I can cast is Hymn to Turok once I cast this Mana Prism, but I think I have expectation of drawing lands here. Can I have a counterspell for blue and one? I cannot think of one. We just... Oh, Power Sink. Well, that's bad news. I could very easily just never cast another spell this game. Alright, not a huge deal, but... Annoying, but I still just have to hit my opponent here. I really just... Drawing a swamp was excellent, by the way. If I draw a second... just another land in a row, and then I can Predatory Nightstalker a Krovakin Sorcerer, that's a big deal, because right now my opponent is going to be looting it up. Ooh, with Deep Analysis, too. My opponent's pretty high in the value chain, a little higher than I am. Well, at least attacking with that's semi-good, semi-bad. At least my opponent's not getting value off it. Oh, man, I really want to cycle Solar Blast. I don't really want to do anything here, almost, because I think... Casting Solar Blast on Krovakin Sorcerer, especially when my opponent just didn't use it last turn, seems pretty lame. I think I'm in better shape just casting Solar Blast on whatever my opponent plays next and then killing Krovakin Sorcerer with something else. Or if my opponent doesn't play anything, just hoping to draw another red and killing it that way. Yeah, Phyrexian Defiler, I'm just going to cast Solar Blast on that. And then any land and I get to Predatory Nightstalker away the Krovakin Sorcerer and be in good shape. Expunging that seems bad. Let's just cycle expunge, leaving black-red up, I guess. I was worried about Chain Lightning, and then I drew the one blue card that could really punish me there. Maybe that was a mistake, though. I mean, maybe Baleful Strix is more important than Chain Lightning. Who knows? Chain of Edict still in the yard here. Krovakin Sorcerer potentially active now? I guess it's not really getting card advantage, though, so it's not a huge deal. Let's see what my opponent does next. Predatory Nightstalker potentially getting worse at all. What are we choosing? Choose red? Ugh, got my Starstorm. I have so few red cards in my deck, and my opponent does not know that. That is a shame, but Starstorm is getting got. Alright, so Starstorm is getting taken. I still really need to draw a land here. I guess I'm not under huge pressure. Let's just play Baleful Strix. If I played Phyrexian Defiler and my top card isn't land, then I'd be much happier playing Strix. If I played Baleful Strix and my top card was a land, I'd be a little annoyed, I guess, but given that it wasn't, I'm happier just playing Strix than Defiler, since attacking my opponent is not going to do much here. Alright, land. Now's the time. No, 5-drop. Let's play Defiler, because I don't really want to be locked into playing Ring of Gix here. And pass the turn. I'll probably just block the Kenai Avan with Baleful Strix. Defiler also trades for Kenai Avan. I guess I'm not blocking this turn. And either way, I mean, I'm going to get something Chainer's Edicted, so... Is the Krovakin Sorcerer really not getting used? That is so bad for me. Means my opponent's hand is just great. I doubt it's actually correct for my opponent not to use it. I mean, I don't know my opponent's hand, but if you have anything, you know, reasonable at all, and like that isn't just the best in hand, you should probably be using your Krovakin Sorcerer. I mean, attacking is fine, but in a turn where you did not attack with it, you should probably be using it. But my opponent's hand might just be that great, in which case I am in big trouble. All right, I probably need to land this turn. That really doesn't count. I've got to play Phyrexian Defiler to stay on the board here. And if I don't draw a land next turn... Well, we're already in pretty bad shape. So if I get Chainer's Edicted here, I guess I sacrifice the Baleful Strix. Yeah, because if I sacrifice the Defiler, then everything attacks. If I sacrifice the Strix, now just Idle and Kenai have an attack. I'm just going to block the Chimeric Idol here. I think that's fine. I've got enough ways to kill all the other things. I just want to take the least amount of damage possible. Normally I like Deep Analysis, but this is not one of those times. If I play Ring of Gix, I stop Kenai Avan twice. I guess that's fine. It's painful, but it's fine. I don't think I can afford to play Mana Prism here. Well, at the very least, I go to 9. I'm just dead to Liquidus' champion, but I'm probably not going to beat Liquidus' champion this game no matter what. Man, getting stuck on all 5 drops for on 4 lands for many, many turns is going to make this hard. All right, now Nightscape Familiar is getting cashed in. And Swamp getting discarded. Because right now I'm going to tap a 2 power creature, and then I'm going to hit down to 9. Next turn I'm going to do the same, get hit down to 6. Or I could have taken 5 down to 7, then played Predatory Nightstalker, I guess. Well, Deep Analysis doesn't kill me, but I cannot imagine I'm in good shape here. Least my opponent didn't play a creature this turn. I really needed to also rattle off multiple lands in a row. I guess given that my top two, I need like a bunch of my top cards to be lands, maybe it's better to Deep Analysis, play a land, next turn, play a land and a Dark Hatchling. Actually, we're not getting attacked for that much, so this is working out all right. Oh, never mind. Aquamiba just adds an X factor to the table here. All right. Pay Echo. Well, I didn't draw a land, so I think I'm basically just dead here. I mean, my opponent can't not see Liquidus' Champion. They've drawn their like entire deck at this point, so I'm gonna tap Aquamiba and just die is my assumption. But hey, what can you do, right? I mean, had I been able to cast Predatory Nightstalker, 8 turns ago or whatever, and then followed up with Dark Hatchling, I actually think I'd be in okay shape, or at least we'd have a game. I'm not saying I would have won, because I think that's a little premature. But Doctor Squadron looks very good against this, Chainer's Edict deck here. On the other hand, I'm getting destroyed, so who knows? Well, I made it to the finals, and I got I guess I got a Ring of Gix for my trouble. Animate Deading Scrivener. All right, I can appreciate that. Getting back power sync. Yeah. We are done here. All right. Well, another moderately successful draft, and at least I got to, draft a sweet control deck, so that part's nice.